comme le corbeau et la colombe, s'est trouvé sur le même perchoir dans l'arche de Noé. Ainsi, le champ de Naboth s'est trouvé à côté du palais du roi Akab.
Akab était allé voir Naboth pour lui faire une proposition de lui vendre son héritage
qu'il avait. Avant d'appeler le prédicateur, si Frédéric, je te bénisse, avant d'appeler le prédicateur, je voulais mentionner quelque chose que j'ai oublié. Nous sommes éprouvés ici à l'église. Il y a le frère Joseph Lembo qui a perdu sa belle sœur, c'est-à-dire la petite sœur de la sœur Homme, décédée à Kinshasa, une mort brusque. Elle avait quelques malaises et après elle a succombé. Donc nous sommes éprouvés. Si vous avez le temps, passez pour consoler la famille éprouvée. Amen. Nous croyons à l'amour. Ce message nous a apporté l'amour. C'est dans les moments difficiles qu'il faut assister les frères. Nous avons notre boîte de fond derrière là-bas. C'est là-bas que nous le mettons. S'il y a des invités, s'ils ne savent pas, il y a la boîte de fond là-bas. Si vous avez quelque chose, et passez, mettez là-bas. Amen. Voilà tout ce que j'avais comme communiqué. Et à présent, je vais appeler le prédicateur, c'est le frère François de Dublin, qui va nous apporter la parole aujourd'hui. Amen. Je pense que vous êtes prêts pour recevoir. Amen. Frère François, tu peux nous dire. Sentez-vous à l'aise, vous êtes ici, c'est votre maison. Vous allez jouer ici, si vous en avez besoin, vous ouvrez juste ici. Amen.
Écrit to all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I hope you are all ready.
Amen.
Your question, Brother Anderson. It was a good one.
Yeah.
Come at the right time. Brother Eric is a good friend of mine.
Yeah.
I'll apologize not to preach in French because I prepare my notes. All my English, bear with me. I'll try my best that we can move together.
Yeah.
It's very glad to see Brother Enoch. Brother Enoch is my brother from Dublin, long time together. Become like my young brother.
Amen.
I appreciate the support.
Amen.
Always where I am, to always be there.
Amen.
Thank you, and we bless you all.
Amen.
I can see some familiar faces, like Brother, touching now, Brother Eli.
Yes, sir.
He's my good friend.
Amen.
He came many times to Dublin to visit us.
Yes, sir.
We had many good times there. Without any delay, let's stand and open our Bible, our precious Bible. Let's go to Genesis chapter 2. Genesis chapter 2. We're going to start from verses 16 to 17. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest eat freely, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die. Let's go to Matthew chapter 4. Just one verse there. Verse 4. This was the answer of the Lord Jesus Christ to Satan. But he answered and said, it is right. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God.
Amen.
Let's bow our head and offer our prayer. Most precious is the Heavenly Father, this morning we come humble before thy throne of mercy to thank you for the privilege that you have given to us to be able to be in thy house. Like David said together, we are glad to be in thy house. Father, everybody that has the ability to read can read the Bible, but we know the inspiration and the right interpretation of it come only from thee.
Amen.
That's why this morning, as the prophet says, the gift is the ability to put yourself aside,
yes,
and let the Lord use you.
Amen.
I put myself aside this morning,
yes,
that you may use me,
yes,
for the benefit of thy children. Because they didn't come here to see a man, they come to me to wait for you, Father.
Yes.
Paralyze all my senses. Anything that's of me should not be seen, but you alone to be seen among thy people. Father, we ask you that if there is an unspoken request, because we are needy people, and we ask you that you look down from heaven with the eyes of mercy and answer to our request. Without thee, we can't do nothing. And you are faithful to thy appointment. You say, where two or three are gathered in thy name, you shall be in thy midst.
Yes.
We are more than 10 in this place, and we believe that you are with us.
Amen.
And your prophet tell us, wherever this message will be preached,
yes,
the angel of the Lord will be there.
Amen.
And we believe this morning that the angel of the Lord that was able to discern the thoughts and the intents of the hearts of the people is with us this morning, and is ready to do the same job this morning. Father, bless Father Eric. Bless the congregation. Bless his Lord and his wife and his family, Father. And this is the remaining of the time that we're going to spend together. Let you move freely in this audience, Father. If there's anything that could hinder your presence this morning, Father, we cast it out from this place to the dry ground in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We remember our sisters that he has lost the dear one, Father, and take on her behalf. Take control of the family where our weight can't reach inside of the heart. You may be able to reach there, Father, that you may comfort them, give them courage, and take control of the whole family back in Congo, and the brother and the sister. Bless them and be with them, Father. We commit the remaining of the service at thy hand in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Then we say, Amen.
Amen.
You may enjoy the comfort of your seat while you remain stable for the work of the Lord. I think it's a great privilege, as I say, to stand here before you. It's already a privilege. You can't take it for granted to stand before the children of God. You appreciate it. And once again, thank you, Brother Eric. Now this morning, we want to look at something that may attest to you. I hope the word of God is always something good. That's the purpose that we are here this morning. Just from what we read in the book of Matthew, chapter 4, Jesus tells us here, but he answered and said, it is right, and man shall not live by bread alone, but by every way that proceeds out of the mouth of God.
Amen.
Now, if you go back to the beginning, in Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, you're going to see that the first man that God created, he created the man is on his own image.
Yes.
And the prophet tells us that then, when you get to Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, we find that another man was created, and he was created from the ground. God took the ground and the blood, and the man was standing. And God didn't stop there, and he blew the life,
yes,
and the man became a living soul.
Amen.
And God, when he created the first man, It was in the image of God. And we know that when you speak in the man in the image of God, we don't speak about the physical form that we are in. Because we know that the physical form that we are in is the mammal form.
Yes.
The prophet tells us that this physical form that we are, it's animal form.
Yes,
it's not the form.
Amen.
And we see that the first man was in the image of God, but he was put in this form.
Yes.
And man now become two in one.
Yes.
He has the physical body and he has the soul that is inside of him. And from the beginning of it, in Genesis chapter 1, let's go back there and make a background there before we get to our main topic, Genesis 1, from verse 26, then we can move together. And it says, and God said, let's make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl and of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth.
Yes.
And so God created man in his own image.
Yes.
And in the image of God created him, male and female.
Yes.
Created him.
Yeah.
Now we see that God created them, male and female. But the first thing that we saw when God went to create Adam, created a physical body, an envelope. That's as the prophet says, I always wonder where am I myself, because it says I have five fingers, but you can't see me. My name is Francois, but you can't see me, you can only see the envelope.
Amen.
That's
yes,
representative Francois.
Yes.
Francois has a watch, but where is Francois actually? Inside.
Yes.
Now we understand that God make a man now to become the inward man and the outward man.
Yes.
And both of those men, they're gonna only live by a dead substance.
Mm. Uh-huh.
Now today we just have a small topic here. We want to look at the law. And our topic this morning, we want to look at go back to the first one. How can you get the first one by here? If you can comment from there. I'm not very familiar with this device. Technology, sometimes you must get used with it. You get to the first one. You start with the first one. Let's go back to the first one. First one. One drink. Go back to the first one. The first. Over there. Just one drink. Backward.
Backwards.
Yeah, then one click. Okay, that's good. Now this morning, our topic this morning. Okay, very good. We'll be looking at the law of eating and life. Now because God created those both man, the inner one and the outside man. The time that we are living in, before we get there, we live in a time that people are so cautious. And they are very careful on what they are eating. That's in the natural. And we find that from the last decade, last 10 years, there's so much business, a lot of business around the healthy food. Many businesses, it never happened like that before. We find many shops 10 years ago, we never find it. Because people know somehow. And this research study shows that there is a positive correlation between life expectancy and the things that we eat.
Yeah.
It has a direct relationship and a strong relationship. Now, everything that we do in this life, it has to get somewhere. And we know that a law is a set of rules a set of way of conduct that's set by certain authorities to direct, to govern a community or a state or a different parts of the people, that they must be ruled by that law. And you know that in God there's many law.
Yes.
And prophets tell us there's many law, and in science there's also many law.
Yeah.
There's law of gravity, many different law. But today we want to look at a special one.
Yes.
It's the law of eating and life.
Right.
And we find that in this life, for us to stand here this morning, something must die for us to stand.
Yes.
Here.
Yes.
There's no way where you can have a life.
Yes.
Without death.
Yes.
Yes.
There's nobody, there's no science that can say contrary to that.
Amen.
Even people who doesn't eat meat, something must die.
Yes.
For them to live.
Yes, yes.
If you may say I don't eat meat, but the life of a tree or of a vegetable.
Yes.
Must die for you to stand this morning.
Yes, sir.
It must die for you to be able to wake up, to go to work.
Mm-hmm.
For you to renew your blood cell, you must eat something.
Yes.
And something that can give you power to walk.
Yes.
Now, there's nobody can say is contrary from that.
No.
It is one of the one things that even sciences agree with it. All we live by dead substance. There's nobody can escape it. That is natural. There's nobody can escape that. That for you to be able to be healthy, you must eat. You must eat something. Without eating, you can't stand. And we're going to bring that to the spiritual one. That if the physical man has to depend on dead substances, is the same thing for the spiritual man to. For the spiritual man to live, he must also eat by dead substances. Something must die for us to live in physically and in spiritually also. Something must die that you may live. Otherwise, we will not live. Because if you stop eating for many days, you're going to die. They're going to bring you to hospital.
Yes.
And they're going to bring you in emergency. And if the doctors are not careful, they'll be looking at something else. But what you need is nothing but just food. Now you must realize that it's very important in our physical life. And as we say, there's so much healthy food, shops, and all these things. Because people know that food has direct effect with our body. And sometimes people with us, like us, we having a lot of weight. When you go to the doctor, sometimes you don't prescribe anything for you. He will just tell you that change your way of eating.
Yes, sir.
Because otherwise, you won't live longer.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that is something very important. But people are so careful about this physical body that we are in. And people, nobody will like to eat poison. Because you know that once you eat poison, you're going to die.
Yes.
It's something that we all look at this body. But no matter what you're going to look at this body, the gravity show us that from the ground that we're coming from, we have to return there.
Yes.
And the prophet agree with that. There's a gravity of God, because God says, from the ground you come from, you have to return back to the ground.
Yes.
No matter what you're going to do, you can spend a million.
Yes.
Of looking at this boy, one day this boy is going to disappoint you.
Yes.
Now we don't want to spend so much time in something that's going to disappoint us.
Yes.
There's nothing wrong for all of us to take care of our body.
Yeah.
But we must know, we must bear it in mind that no matter what, even we can't die with sickness or with anger, but the old age will catch us.
Yeah.
And we will live this earth.
Yeah.
That's something very important.
Yes.
To bear in mind that it's very important. It's a principle that we can't go away of it. We must always live by a dead substance. Now, we know that the principle there, there's some rules of the game there. Let's read one quote from the prophet there, and that to show what we're talking about. And the prophet said, you can only live because something died.
Mm.
Every day something has to die, so you can live physically.
Amen.
If you eat beef, the cow died.
Yes.
If you eat pork, the hog died.
Yes.
You can only live by a dead substance.
Yes.
And we are all agree for that. There's nobody that can live without a dead substance.
Amen.
That's a principle of the Word of God and the principle of life. That's why every day you must take a breakfast, you must eat, you take our dinner because we want to be in good form. We want to be healthy. It's so important in our life.
Amen.
Now we see that in the spiritual realm, it has to apply the same principle. But though even we live by dead substance, you can't eat anything that you find in the market.
Amen.
Because some of the food, they are dog food. They are not made for human. Humans are not ordained to eat that.
That's true.
Now that's it. We get there and you find there's many churches. But that are not made for the children of God.
Yes, sir.
Because that is not the message of the hour.
Hallelujah.
Because those are dog food, you have nothing to do with them. If you eat them, it's going to cause harm to your life.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes.
Now, there's some poison food that you can't eat. Because if you eat, you're going to separate yourself from you people, from your dear one. Now, but there's some rules in the game. That as the law, we see that every law has some rule on it. And even when you go to the supermarket, every food that you're going to find there, you must eat it, the food in due season. You go to Tesco, they will tell you on the food, they must put a label, and they must tell that it is best to be taken between this certain date.
Yes.
If out of date, they can't put it on the shelf anymore.
Yes.
If they put it on the shelf, if someone bites and has some problem, they can bring them to court.
Yeah.
And when they bring them to court, they can make some pounds.
Yeah.
Probably maybe 15,000, a lot of money, because of just a simple thing.
Amen.
Now, in the natural, things apply the same way. You must eat the food in due season. Now, you can't bring the message of a liver.
Amen.
And give to the people now, it will not work because it's out of date.
Amen.
It's going to cause problems in the life of the people.
Amen.
It won't help them any longer because it's not in due season. You bring Wesley message now,
Amen.
It's not going to work because it's not in due season.
Yes.
Now people must understand why the difference between the message and the message of Wesley. And all the message of Luther, there's a great difference. That's what we want to find here,
yes.
And to see that if you must eat by dead substance, but though we eat by dead substance, but not any kind of the food that you must eat. Now the first rule is that you must eat the food in due season.
Amen.
It will not go out of season, because if it's out of season, it's gonna cause a problem,
yes.
And you catch one of the disease. And those diseases, sometimes they are very dangerous.
Mm.
They kill the people.
Yes.
But if you're still eating from sources that are not the message, it's going to kill your spiritual life.
Yes.
You will not progress because it's not the food in due season.
Yes.
It has nothing to do with you. That's why denomination church, they can't overcome the time that we are living in, because they are eating food that is out of the season. They're eating food that is out of the season, spiritually speaking, is not meant to be eaten now. The message of Luther, the message of Wesley, it was good when it was in the time of Wesley. But in this time, it can't work anymore. The reason they can't overcome the fashion of this world, because they are not eating from the message of the hour.
Yes.
If someone that is spiritually eating from the message of the hour, it's an easy thing for someone to forsake dressing, trouser, and all those things, because he sees clearly that the Lord has moved and he has provided something that can minister life in this time. And the only things that can give life is the message that can give you life. The message has the power to transform you, to take the desire of putting on trousers and make you able to put a dress. Because it's on due season, it's not out of season. But when something is out of season, it causes trouble in your life.
Mm.
Now, and we see that the second thing there that you must see. Now, if you look now in the market, you go to Tesco, down the store, whatever you're going to go there, you find that there's two sections of food. Some of them are organic food, and some of them are hybrid food. The normal food, we almost use it. The organic food are not sell on the same price as the hybrid one.
No.
There's a great difference of the price there. The reason the difference is in the price, because organic is not mixed with anything. Mm. It's natural food. It comes from the ground, the way God has made it. There's no chemical on it. Mm. But most of the food that we eat, and it has consequence in our body, and spiritually speaking, has the same thing.
Amen.
Because the scripture says, remember the prophet tell us about the Reader Digestion magazine. When they come with the coat, the doctor says that the food we eat, it causes even young women to go to menopause at the age of 22 years old.
Yes.
Because the food has an impact in our body.
Yes.
Now, in the spiritual things, it's the same thing.
Yes, sir.
When you are not eating the pure way,
yes.
When you are not eating the pure message of Malachi 4,
yes.
You get to spiritual menopause.
Yes, sir.
That you can't afford this life anymore. There's no life. You'll just be a church member. But so much on YouTube, so much eating for wrong sources, you will have no life. There's no life. Because you are not eating from the right source.
Yes.
You are eating mixed, the hybrid food. And it has a problem. And the prophet says it can cause even disorder in the teeth of the children. I have that experience with my own daughter. When my daughter was born, all the teeth come together normal. But after a time, there was a disorder on the way the teeth come out. And we went to the doctor, and the doctor says, it's because of the food that we eat. And I said, mind, this has a serious impact in the life of the people. Now, if you bring it spiritually, it has more effort, more impact than what it is in the natural.
Yes.
You find some people, they can't produce life anymore. They can't, anything good can't come out of them anymore.
Yes.
They stopped producing the life because there's a hybrid food. They are not eating pure message.
Yes.
When they are eating something else that is mixed, they can't produce life anymore.
Yes.
That's why you can't see Christian life anymore. You can see and can feel that there's something wrong with the sister. There's something wrong with the brother. Because he's not eating the organic food anymore. Something has caused his spiritual life to stop producing the fruit of the spirit. Because from what he's eating. But if you eat so much from Hollywood, we can only see Hollywood in your life.
Yes, yes.
We can't, we will not be able, you will not be able to produce the life of Christ.
Amen.
You're gonna stop, you go to quick menopause because of what you are eating. Now it's one of the rules that we must watch a lot.
Yes.
We must watch a lot. There's nothing wrong, as we said, with the eating, because God, like we saw that hybrid. It has a serious consequence in the life of the people. That the prophet tells us, the quote, I will bring back the quote later for me, for you. That to show that it's one of the things that is very important in the principle, in the law of eating and life. Because it stops you from producing. And the prophet says the food that we eat, it helps us to renew our blood cell. In the physical speaking, in the spiritual speaking. Is that if you stop from eating, reading the Bible, listening to the message, it's gonna cause a problem in your spiritual life. Something must happen, but this is one of the things that people are not, they don't like it. Because it goes directly to the heart of the people. Because people doesn't like when you tell them that you must live a pure and clean life, the life of the gospel.
Yes.
We must always go back and eat in the message. But when we mix, you don't take 5 minutes to see that there's something wrong. Because you can see the attitude, it's gonna reflect for us coming to church. Our attitude in the things of God, it changed. There's no that life anymore because we're mixing. We're mixing with the world with the things of God. And it can't be mixed, it must be the pure things. When we start being involved now in speaking bad about our pastors, speaking evil about our sisters, we stopped eating from the right source.
Yes.
But once we continue eating from the message, you won't speak anything wrong against your sister.
Yes.
You will have no wrong thoughts against your sister. Because you are eating the organic food. It's not a hybrid. The message tell it that if you have a problem with your brother, go and speak to him.
Yes, sir.
No. Not go speak behind him. Go and fix the things with your brother.
Yes.
If you have a problem with your sister, go speak to him,
yes,
to her. Not call another sister and start telling her,
yes,
did you see what the sister did to me? Did you see the way she came to church today? It show a sign that something wrong. That the person is not eating anymore from the right source.
Yes.
And once you stop from eating there, it's quick. Those behavior in your life, it can show you that you are already in menopause. You are not producing the life anymore. Because you are made to produce the life.
Yes.
And you're supposed to produce the life in daily basis. Not once a month. Every day you are made to produce that life.
Yes.
And that life must be seen before the people. You don't wait when you have that life in you. When you are eating in the message, even you will be the only one to be in Sunday school. You will be the only one. Because you know that the scripture tells you to do so. If nobody is coming, if everybody is against the white the pastor preached last Sunday, but you will still agree with it. Because you know that the man is not standing for himself. He's standing for the message. What he preached is the message. I will agree with it.
Amen.
That's the scripture. Now, we get here in the third one. Now, the food that we must eat, it has to be the right food. We look at that one before. It must be the right one. If it's not the right one, something wrong.
Yes.
Because if you eat poison, you're gonna die. We're going to bring that to something else. We try to build small, until when we get what we want to build. I'm sure that you must eat from the right source.
Yes.
And the last one, you must eat all of it.
My.
Amen.
Yes,
that's
sir.
The scripture. Now, we go back to Genesis. Let's go to Genesis, to Exodus chapter 12. When the Hebrew children, they come out of Egypt, they have to do a Passover. The Lord tells them to kill the lamb. When they kill the lamb, and they must eat the lamb. But it was told that they must eat all of it.
Yes.
They should not choose. This is the part of the message. I will agree with it.
My.
They can't, you can't choose. You,
yes,
can't,
sir,
say, no, I believe this because it's okay for me.
My.
Even when it's not okay for you.
Yes, sir.
Because it is the message you must believe.
Amen. Yes, sir. So, yes.
If it doesn't agree with your life, because sometimes as a human being, we go astray, we go behave ourselves,
yes,
contrary to the word of God. But when the word of God comes, even does not agree with us,
yes,
we must agree with it.
Amen.
Because the word doesn't come to deal with you, it comes to deal with the sin or the problem that is in your life. The message has come to help you, not to condemn you.
No.
It's come to deal with the problem that is in your life.
Yes, yes.
And it's been told that when you eat the Passover, you must eat the whole lamb.
Yes.
Eat the leg, eat the head, eat the eyes, everything must be eaten.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You can't choose.
Yes.
No, we are living in Europe. I can't do that.
I can do this
to my husband. No, that is not the message.
My.
The message says that you must submit to your husband.
My.
Even when you live in Europe, you have to do that because that is the scripture.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You can't do contrary to that.
My.
Otherwise, you are choosing what is good for you.
My.
We're living in the civilization where everything is against the word of God.
Yes.
Things that we saw, the law is against the word of God. I heard Brother Eric was telling the children how science teach that man comes from monkey. I can't believe that nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
You believe the word of God that says God created man in his own image.
Yes.
He didn't say that God take man from monkey. Now that's what the big problem, especially here in Europe, is this part. We don't want to eat all of it.
Yes.
We want to eat certain parts of the lamb and put it aside. But it's been told to the Hebrew children, you must eat the whole of it.
Yes, sir.
The leg must be eaten.
Yeah.
The head must be eaten.
Mm.
Now the big problem here is because we get policemen, we get social workers. Now it become problem even to the sisters in the message that to submit to the husband. It become problem. They say, "Ah, we are in Europe." What Europe has to do with the message?
What?
The message remains the message,
yes,
no matter where you're gonna take it. And the prophet says, a child of God, even you take him or her to the jungle, you're gonna see the child of God.
Yes.
Nothing gonna change. And the message didn't change.
Yes.
This society has their own laws. But as a sister and brethren, we must live the way of the message.
Yes.
Mm. If the scripture says, brother, you must love your wife, you must love your wife.
Yes.
Because sometimes we go straight to the mystery. But those basis of the scripture,
yes,
that make us Christian, we don't have them anymore.
Yes.
Yeah.
Are we just aiming about ministry, even mysteries? Oh no, seven thunders, all those seven thunder things, they are good.
Yes.
We believe on them.
Yes.
But let's have the life.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because that without life, it has no meaning.
Amen. Yes, sir.
We just a name.
Yes.
Now that we can find all these churches. And if you go, you tell the people, denomination church, that woman can't wear trousers, they can't put makeup, they're going to tell you that was Paul. It's nothing to do. That if you hear those kind of preaching, it must be Paul or Branham. What does it have to do with Paul and Branham? It's the word of God.
Yes.
You must take it. There's nothing to do with it.
Yes.
The scripture says a woman must dress in a decent way. What has to do with Branham? Or Paul, this is the scripture, it's the word of God.
Sure.
You must dress decent. The reason why? Because you be called an adulterer. Because Jesus says, whoever look at a woman with the eyes of lust already committed adultery.
Yeah.
And you don't commit adultery yourself.
Yeah.
And the prophet said, you may say, I'm virtual to my husband. Mm. I never committed adultery before.
Mm.
But at the day of the judgment, because of your way that you present yourself, your way of dressing, God is going to bring you guilty of adultery because you willingly put yourself in that way. Now when we find people going to church and dressed in a way that can show all their shape, everything, you must find something wrong. That they're not eating from the right source.
Yes.
Because if they eat from the right source, they know that the message will not allow this thing. Now, where else they can eat? There's many places where you can eat spiritually speaking. We have a YouTube, but we have all those magazines and everything from Facebook. And you can see that the life of the people start reflecting. One lady at work dressed a certain way, even the children of God, so-called Christian, they want to dress that way. How can the children of God cope with the people of Sodom? Because that the trouble of Lot to get is when he went to join himself with the people of Sodom. That way he missed to see Elohim when he came to visit Abraham.
Yeah.
He could not see him because he behaved himself like the people of Sodom.
Amen.
But now we thank God because God has sent us the message. And the message has given us ability to know what is wrong and what is right.
Yes.
And the message has given us everything that we need to walk according to the word of God. Now we see that this law of eating and death, that the first time in the history of the Bible, where God manifested himself, he did it, it was with a purpose.
Yes.
That the first time that the manna come from heaven, when the children of Israel, they come out of Egypt, they come, that was the first Exodus.
Yes.
And you will see that it's always in the Exodus time that the Lord rained the manna from heaven.
Amen.
And it's not done by chance. It's done with a purpose. Because the Lord knows that this is a critical junction. That the people need something from heaven to give them life.
Yes.
Now the Hebrew children,
amen,
let's go to Exodus. Exodus chapter 16 from verse 15. And when the children of Israel saw it, they said to one another, "It is manna, for they wist not what it was." And Moses said unto them, "This is the bread which the Lord has given to eat, has given you to eat."
Yes.
Now we say that the Lord knew that these people, they come out of Egypt, they need something to eat.
Yes.
for them to continue to get to the promised land, because they're crying about the food. And the Lord knows that they need something to eat. And this was in the first Exodus. And that was the first time in the history of the Bible that the Lord ran food from heaven to provide the need of his people. But you find something wrong with these people. That when they get to the book of Numbers, they start complaining about this manna, that the Lord, a special dish that comes from heaven, the angel made food, and the Lord sent them on earth. They're supposed to rejoice in it. They're supposed to be glad that the cucumber and the things that we were eating in Egypt. But you find that in number, they start murmuring. They say, we're tired of these things. We're tired of this manna. And my, this was from heaven. These people should appreciate it. That's what we come to a certain time. I'm tired about this thing. All the time they come, Brother Branham said it. Brother Branham said this. Women should not do this. Brother, you should not do this. I'm tired of hearing this all the time. That the reason why? Because they come out of Egypt, but Egypt was in them.
Yes.
Amen. Egypt never went out of them. That was the reason. They come out of Egypt physically, but spiritually, they still desire the life of Egypt. And when people get problem, they just have the head knowledge of the message. But Egypt is still inside of them. But now they have to be a spiritual now change of gastronomy. Something has to change inside. The Lord must change the inside for him to be able to deal with them faithfully. That should be able to be glad that, no, these kings of the world, I have no time to look at them anymore. Because we've been there. The same food that kept us as a slave there, I have nothing to do with them. I will not go on to eat these things of Egypt. It was because of what happened with our brethren, the family of Jacob. They hate their own brother, because the prophet says in the spoken word Exodus, the third Exodus, he said the reason Hebrews went to Egypt, it was because of jealousy. Now, brethren, you must be careful with that one. Jealousy can send you to prison in Egypt. When you are jealous of your brother, when you are jealous of your sister, maybe she's prospering than you. Do not be jealous of her. Do not be jealous of your brother. Be happy. The Lord will bless you. But when the children of Israel, they were jealous of Joseph's spiritual life, the prophet said that was the reason that they went to celebrate in Egypt. If Brother Eric is doing well, I must be happy. Because he's my brother. But the children of Jacob didn't see things that way. They want to see Joseph suffering. And we are Christian, we are not here to put one another like the children of Jacob. They put Joseph in the grave. We want to lift up one another. Yes. If our brother is down, we must do all that we can to help the brother or the sister to stand up again. Yes. Because we are together. We are in the army of the living God. We need one another. But these people of Jacob, they didn't realize that they're going to pay for what they did for Joseph. And they went there 400 years. And it was more than 400 years because they were so jealous to Joseph. And God made a way, because God has made the promise. And he says he will visit them. He will send them the prophet and take them out of Egypt. And us, we are living in the spiritual Egypt.
Yes.
And the Lord promised to visit us. And the only way that the Lord visited his people, by sending his messenger. And when he visited them, he sent Moses.
Yes.
That was the first Exodus. Now in the third Exodus now, when the Lord visited us, he sent us for a runner to take us out of spiritual Egypt.
Yes.
To bring us to the promised land.
Yes.
Now, that's the way, that's how the things work. And we saw that the Lord ran the food because they need food. The Lord knew that they didn't yet get to the promised land. I must provide food. And the Lord provided food to them. Now, in the second part in the Bible, where we found that food ran from heaven, let's go to John chapter 4, That was the second Exodus. That God rained the food from heaven. But people still not get used with it. Because people are so much used to their own tradition, to their own way they grown up. Maybe they grown up with the pirates that were Protestant, the pirates that were Catholic. They thought that the message has to come the way of Catholic. It doesn't come that way.
No.
And the message comes the way of God.
Amen.
And that way of God is by sending his message.
Yes, sir.
That's the only way that God can bring the things to his people.
Mm.
Now in John chapter 6, verse 47, the scripture says, this was the word of Jesus. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me has everlasting life.
Mm.
Now, we know that the second part of our body, which is the soul, must also live by the dead substance.
Mm.
Now, the physical part we saw on the first Exodus, it has to be that way, the Lord suspended. And the second part of it, and the Lord Jesus Christ said, I am that bread of life. Now, it's going to be a big trouble here. People are going to fight it. They will not like it. And he said, you, Father, did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. Why? Because this was just a type. They ate the manna in the wilderness, but all are dead. Because that was for the physical body and can't now challenge the law of God. Because the Lord says, from the ground you are taken, you have to go back to the ground. No matter what they have to eat in this body has to go back to the ground. It has to be go back to the ground. The prophet said, even for the rapture, it must be a sharp pen. This body must be dropped down and we use another body. It has to happen that way. There's nowhere where this corrupt the things. It can inherit the things of God.
No.
Now, it can't happen. Because the Lord said, from the ground you were taken, you must go back there. Mm-hmm. And he said, you, Father, did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. This is the bread which comes down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and not die. He wasn't speaking about this physical man. And they misunderstood everything completely. He was speaking about the soul, but the people were so much used of tradition, of Pharisees cheating. They could not understand the message of Jesus. And they said, I am the living bread which come down from heaven. And if any man eats of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is myself, which I will give for the life of the world. This guy, they didn't understand. They come and say, the Jew, therefore, strove among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? They didn't have the understanding. They didn't have the revelation of the thing. They start arguing with Jesus. But how can this man, they forget that man is two in one. They forget that Jesus was speaking unto them, to the spiritual part of their being, not the physical one, that they must eat his flesh, that they may have a life. Because their father died with physical bread, but now they must eat spiritually for them to live eternal. This body was created, it must have an end. Everything that has a beginning must have an end. Now the only thing that have no beginning is the soul. And that soul which is in the image of God, and God has no beginning. And that's a part of your body that will live eternal. Now if we put so much effort of this physical body, we're supposed to put more effort in the spiritual one. Because no matter what, this will, you will die one day. Even old age will kill you. Sickness didn't kill me, the old age will kill me. That this is what we need to put so much effort. It's our soul. It's how do we feed our spiritual being. It's the most important thing, is to feed our spiritual being. And we're supposed to be more careful to what we eat spiritually. Things that we read, We must be careful on things that we read, because we can die, spiritually speaking, if we read things that is not agreeing with the word of God, things that is not agreeing with the message of Yahweh. We can die, spiritually speaking.
Amen.
Because they are not meant for us to eat, for us to live spiritually. We must have the fresh food from heaven. And God himself must give us something. And God give them food in the second Exodus. But how many people understood that Christ was really food that they need for them to have life? Only 12 of them. 11, that was the minority of the people that understood that this is the food that he need. And you are not expecting in the third Exodus that many people will understand that. Because God does, it doesn't change. Things always work the same way. Do not expect to see a Methodist church like a denominational church. No.
Yes.
You will miss everything.
Yes.
God is not the way people say majority. No.
Amen.
God is always is in quality,
yes,
not in the majority. Because you can have a bunch of the people, 100 people, but there's none of them are going to heaven.
That's true.
I'm sorry to tell you, for denomination, it's difficult for any of them to go to the rapture. How are they going to go there? It's not possible, because they don't have what it takes for them to go to the rapture. You must have something, because we found there was many religions at that time. There was the Pharisees, Sadducees, all of them, but none of them were able to know that Jesus was the bread that came from heaven to give them life. But only few disciples, and when they start, Jesus continued telling them, when they get to verse 66 of John 6, what happened? All of them departed from following Jesus. They said, this man wants to make us a cannibal. And Jesus looked at those guys and tell them, the disciples, you guys, what are you doing here? Your friend already gone. They say, where else can we go?
Yeah.
You alone has the word of eternal life.
Yeah.
That's why we are here this morning, because we have found that the message only have the eternal life.
Yes, sir.
That's why we are not in the denomination group, because we have found that in message alone we can have life. Even other people go back to the denomination church, but I will not go back there, because we have find our blessing is in the message of the hour. That's the only place that we're gonna have eternal life. There's nowhere else you can find, because it's one eternal life. Even in the time of Jesus, it was one eternal life. There was no two eternal life. It was Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, let's get quick now. We coming to get a few minutes. Now, let's go to Revelation chapter 10. Now, that's where we get now. It's the third Exodus now. That's where, for the third time, that God rain manna from heaven and put it in the public, that the people may eat it. But how many people did eat it? It was a few of them. That the same in the time of Jesus. How many people enjoyed to eat the flesh of Jesus? Not many of them. And we found that in the first Exodus, that was the same thing too. How many people did enjoy to eat the manna from heaven? Only the predestinated seed that will agree with the whole word of God.
Amen.
That no matter what it is, what the Bible says, what the message says, that what I will take. No matter what happened, I'm going to take what the message says.
Amen.
No matter where I live, even if I live in America, America has nothing to do with me. The message, that is my constitution.
Amen.
Anything that is not in the message, I'm not going to take it.
Yes.
Now, we get here in Revelation. Let's go to Revelation chapter 10, verse 8. And the voice which I heard from heaven spake unto me again, and says, go and take the little book which is open in the hand of the angel which stand upon the sea, upon the earth. That was John speaking. Says, he told him, go get that. And I went unto the angel and said unto him, give me the little book And then he said unto me, take it and eat it.
Yes.
That's the third time in the Bible we find that God rent the manna now in the form of the book, in the form of the revelation, that he sent the spiritual one and says, take it and eat it. And it shall make thy belly bitter, but it shall be in thy mouth sweet as a honey.
Nice.
It has to do something in the belly. Why? Because it has to change the inside. This is spiritually speaking. It must change like the Hebrew children in the natural. It has to change. Now the gastronomy from Egypt must change now. They must get used to the manna from heaven. Now we know that when the revelation of the word comes, the opening of the seal, and the book was given, and it's John has to take that book, and John that represents you and I, we must take the book and eat it. We have to take the book and eat it. And when we eat the book, we become the book, because the blood cell comes from what we eat. That's where we renew it. When we take the message and we eat it, we must become the message. And we can produce only the life of the message. If you eat the message and cannot produce the life of the message, something wrong. You must be eating something else. Because the message has the power of transformation. It must transform the life of someone. You can't eat the message and remain the same. Nobody in the time of Jesus that met with Jesus and remained the same. No, something has to take place.
Yeah.
When you meet with the word, and the prophet says, the word has the power to transform.
Amen.
The word has the power to change our life from what we used to be before. And he can change the life of a drunkard to make him a saint. But if you didn't eat from it, you can't change. It's not possible to eat from the message and you remain the same. I can't understand that. That is a paradox. You can't understand. How can someone eat the message and not changing? How can someone listening to the message and not changing? You can't understand that. Something must be wrong somewhere. Because when you eat, you must become what you are eating. It's not possible that you eat the message and not producing the life of the message. Because we saw that in the things that we do, in the law of eating and life, we saw that even science proved it, that what we eat, that what we become. Because it has impact on our life. If we eat right, we're going to live longer. If you eat food with a lot of problems, we're going to die quickly. But that's where the question is, are we eating from the message? Because if we eat from the message, we must produce the life of the message.
Amen.
And that life, people must see Christ in us.
Yes.
The way we speak, the way we do our things, Christ must be manifested inside of our life. The problem today with Christianity, that is one of the big hindrances for the life of the people outside. We profess many things. We claim many things. We know a lot of mysteries, but the problem is that we can't live the life that you can call the people to the gospel. If we can only eat the message, we will be able to produce that life. Because when we eat the message, something must happen. And how do we eat the message? We eat the message by reading it, by listening to it. That's the way we eat the message. And the prophet give a good example. Why the prophet give that example of the three markets? The reason the prophet give the example of the three markets that he saw when he went traveling in America, and he saw one of them, he put his hand on the ice. Why? Because the ice is one of the channel that we use to eat spiritual. Put the hand on the ice that he should not see no evil. I should not read no evil. I should not see no evil about my brother, see no evil about my sister. I can only be able to see good. I'm not going to undermine him. I'm not going to undermine her. I'm going to look at her. Maybe she's not yet where the Lord wants her or him to be, but I can see that the Lord is dealing with the person. Something going to happen. But by the moment we use our eyes for reading magazine, for seeing faults of our brother and sister, something wrong. We must question ourselves, are we really using it the right way? And the prophet says, and he saw another one with the hand in the mouth, that I should speak no evil. Speak no evil. That's one of the things that us as Christians, we must learn of it. We must learn, even especially in the message. We know a lot, but things that come out of our mouth sometimes, it can kill you, brother. It can kill you, sister. And it's destroying the affairs of someone. And you left the person with nothing. The way we're going to speak about our brother, we're going to call them heathen. We're going to give them all names. But when the Lord looked at David, when David fell in sin, the Lord didn't look at David the way people look at him. Even David, when he looked at the condition himself, when first Nathan came to him, David wanted to make the judgment. Then the Lord can't make that judgment. David says, I will take vengeance. I will kill the person myself. But when David showed him the vision clear, that my king is not, it's nobody else but yourself, David starts seeking for mercy. If we put ourselves in the shoes of someone else, that is folly. Someone else that is in need, and we put ourselves there, if we are in the same condition, what we will be asking from the Lord? You're going to ask for mercy. You will not speak evil of yourself. If you can't speak evil of yourself, how can you speak evil of someone else?
Yes.
Now, if all this depends, our spiritual life is dependent from what we eat.
Yes. Amen.
Because if we eat from the message, the prophet says, if you have nothing good to speak about your brother, just close your mouth.
Yes, that's true.
Speak nothing. Now, this principle seems to be simple, but it's very deep. Because all this depends. If you read the message, you find a quote like that. It says, my, I can feel that nature, that old nature in me, that desire always to speak evil of about other people. But the word of God I listened this morning, the message, the prophet says, speak nothing against anybody else. You're going to shut your mouth. And the prophet says, hear no evil. But in this world that we are living, there's so many free calls. You can make them on WhatsApp. You can make them on message. You can make them on your bundle. And all these things now, someone will just pick up the phone. You don't need to come and to get Brother Eric to speak about someone else's foot. You can just take your phone and start speaking. But now it's not the only person that is speaking, that is making sin, but you also that give you ears to hear evil about your brother, evil about your sister. The prophet says, hear no evil. We should stop that. And all these things, all those symptoms that we can't produce life anymore, it shows that we stopped somewhere. We are eating hybrid food. We are not eating the message. Because if we are eating from the message, we will not do these things. We will say these things is not in the message. Because when you spend time with the message, maybe you just read it as a duty. Oh, let me listen to the message for 20 minutes because I'm a message believer. You can do that, but it will not produce life. But when you have your own time, that you can spend time with the message, read the message, and get the life behind the message, you will not speak evil of anybody. When you get that to a point where you can pray for yourself and break down in prayer by listening to the message, you have no need to come in here and preach about the trousers. You have no need to come here and preach about makeup, because when you read yourself, you will understand it. When Brother Eric come and preach those things, you will say amen to it. You know, when we come here, we don't need to speak to your sister. Do not call the police for your husband. No, because you know that you can't do that. It's a part of your body. It's the bone of your bone. How can you call yourself a police? No matter what, solve the things according to the message of the hour.
Amen.
But we live in a civilization where they have encouraged all these kind of things. They have shown the expectation going on with it. But if someone really believed the message, if someone taking the message saying, no matter what happened, everything will be fixed according to the message of the hour. Because there's nowhere where you're going to take yourself out of the message and go fix the things which someone has no idea of what happened. This government, they have no idea of how things work. They make some laws that is affecting even themselves, even their own family. The laws that bring even confusion in the life of the people. How will I trust those people that make the laws that man can marry man, woman can marry woman? They don't know even the basis of the things. If the nature itself, they don't know how the nature works. But you're going to take your issue quickly because of a misunderstanding in the house. I'm going to bring this issue to the gallery. I'm going to bring this issue to the police. I'm going to bring this issue to the court. No, that it can't be happening to the children of God. We must check the way we conduct ourselves. And the scripture says the man is the head of the house.
Amen.
No matter what, if you read the message, you read the Bible, you're going to agree with it. But you can't read the message, and you can't be influenced by the message, and not respecting your husband at home. It's not possible, but you can see it common in the life of so-called message sisters, that in the house, the brother is a wife. The brother has no wife. The sister knows everything. The sister is the one who does everything. But where come these things? If we eat from the message, we will produce the life of the message.
Yes.
But something wrong. If we can't do that, we copying someone else. Because in the message, there's no these things there. We must be careful. And now we see that we leave everything that we do, it's bad. By a dead substance. And the way of God was given to us to live spiritual. Because the most pressure that we have sometimes is not in this body, it's in the spiritual realm. That the Lord has to give something that's going to be able to meet with the challenge of this age. That's why the scripture says, when the enemy comes like a flood, the spirit of the Lord raised a standard to meet with it. And this evil age that we are living in, the enemy has come like a flood. That's why the Lord has to send the anointing of the eagle with a message that will equip the people and to be able to stand all the malice, all the things of the enemy, that they can stand and hold the Bible and hold the message and says, no matter what the world says, I will still walking and making my life according to this message. That's very important things. And these topics, they are not popular. But for a church like this, you need those kind of things in the life. Because if the family are not settled, if the message doesn't have preeminence in our family, not only in church, we're going to give a hard time for the church to progress. Because if there's a problem in home, the message has no head in the house. It will be difficult no matter what Brother Eric is going to do. How are we going to try his best to preach? If in your house the message doesn't have a place there, it's going to still have a hard time. Because the first thing is to do it from the family. And we need to take aside Facebook, to take aside YouTube and all these things, and give our time with the message. as the family, we sit together and listen to the message in the coolness of time. And it's going to make things easy. And the people will see the life of Christ in us and will be able to follow us. If the people don't see the life of Christ, no matter how you're going to plan, nobody's going to come. You're going to tell them, God has given us the message. God has sent us the message. And they can't see that life of the message in you. Nobody's going to believe it. People are tired of weight and things like that. They want to see a life. But the only way that you can get life is when you're eating from the right source. When you're eating from the message of the hour, that you can get life.
Amen.
If you are not eating from the message, you will not get life from it. We are running a bit out of time. I'm looking to see him because I'm catching my train, I think, in 1 hour something. Maybe you can stop here today, for Eric. We can continue another day. Because I'm looking at the time, we are already half two. And things are running a bit faster. Maybe you can stand and sing a song. We stop there today. This was an introduction to the things, but again, he told me that Barabai did this way, he just come for one day and going back. Another day, it's a deeper subject. I have many steps to go on it, but I think the Lord has really led me to go this way today. Another time, you're going to go it's a bit deeper to most of the things that we like to hear. But today, the Spirit has led me this way.
Amen.
Let's sing and sing a song, and then we can call Brother Eric to come forward. Yeah. And sing one of the songs, and we talk about the prayer. Yeah. So you can come forward, please. We will use the song.
God bless you. Amen. You may be seated now. God bless you. I really appreciate Brother Francois for this wonderful message. You know, Brother Branham said that if you go to the restaurant and they give you the food and you found the spider inside, you push out the plate and you never eat it. Amen. So we must be careful about what we are eating, because what we are eating is what we are becoming. Yes. Amen. If you eat bread, you become bread. So, all of you are pondos, beans. Yes, if you don't eat, you die, isn't it? Because the food is making the cells of your body. I really appreciate that. But what I'm saying, I'm going to read one quotation, but what I'm saying that in a message called The End Time Seed, a sign seed, he said, if you went down here to buy a bowl of soup and it had a spider in it, he said, you'd sue the restaurant. Why? You wouldn't eat it for nothing, because you are afraid you are going to destroy this body.
Yes.
Brother, don't feel what can destroy the body, but what can destroy both soul and body in hell. If you are particular about your food, you wouldn't eat anything dirty to make this body sick or godly. That's what Barabbas says. So, and then swallow any kind of a creed, for your soul that's eternal. When this body has got to perish, don't you let the devil poke that stuff in your throat. Amen.
Amen.
So you don't eat anything. You must be careful about what you're eating. But I also say that this, that if you bring little message in this time, it's going to kill you. Because that food is due past. If you eat it, it's going to give you death. The same food can give you life today. After the death of, how do you call it? When it's not, how do you call it? That experience in English.
Expired death.
Yeah, sorry. If you eat it after the expired death, it gives you death. Amen. But I want to say that If I bring to you the Pentecostal message, I'll be in Laodicea Church.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes.
So, Brother Branham's job was to take us out of the Pentecostal tradition,
yes,
to take us to where God Himself was.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It's to take us out of Laodicea Church. That's Brother Branham's job.
Amen.
Amen. You can't be with the message of Brother Branham and stay in Laodicea. It's contrary to the word of God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Because his job is to take us out. How? He takes you out by taking out the tradition of Laodicea.
Yes,
that means that we don't have the same understanding than Pentecostal people.
Yes.
In everything.
Yes.
Not the same understanding.
Yes.
Yet we are using the same words, but the understanding behind is the same.
Amen.
When God is talking about death, death is not getting in the coffin. Death is to be separate from God.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Amen. So when God is talking about food, it's not bread, it's not potato. The food is the word of God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. So you get the message in due season.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You must recognize your day and its message. You get another message, it produces death.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. So God bless you. But when I said this, I like what Father Francis said. You may eat the message, you may have all the knowledge of the message, but the good thing is to become the message.
Yes.
What you eat is what you become.
Yes.
But I want to say this. In the message called Divine Love, he said this. Now, there's only one thing the church has to do. If you want somebody to come to Christ, you'll be salty.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Salt, it says salt makes a thirst. You'll be salty and be warm, and the world will get thirsty. That's right. If you want to draw someone to Christ, you must give the message.
Amen.
But when you say that, leave your message instead of preaching the word. All of us, we are preachers.
Amen.
Even sisters, children, we are preachers.
Amen.
How do you preach the message? By leaving the message.
Amen.
So let the people see the way you're leaving the message, and it's good to make them thirsty to follow the message.
Amen.
And so many people say that, long time I used to think that you message deliver, you are an example,
yeah,
which you can follow. But now you're doing things like us.
Amen.
Amen. That's not nice.
That's right.
So we must try to change those things. Let us bring the message in the way of the Bible preaches.
Yes, sir.
Leave me a sermon. I'll never like to make a deal with a brother, and after that brother will get my money, never bring it back to me.
Yeah.
You never like it. If I do it today, I thank everyone who leave the church.
Amen.
So you are expecting Brother Eric to be serious in what he's doing, isn't it? Because I'm proclaiming to be Christian, I must leave that. Amen. May God bless you. So, Brother Francois, God bless you. So we are expecting to come back and finish your message.
Amen.
Amen. So we are going to sing Come and Dine Again.
Amen.
After eating this wonderful food, but now we are going to sing it in French. Amen. So today it was our English meeting. Did you enjoy it?
Amen.
Mother Prince, did you enjoy it?
Yes, sir.
English meeting, yeah. So I think we must change things, because we are living in England, we have to preach in English, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So we are always French speakers, even in England. That's not too good. So, yes, you are in interview.